that we can get this chance. But I want to tell you a story, a small one. That when I became minister of ICT, I lived here in Nyeri, so the first place I came and I wanted to do things was here in Nyeri. But Safaricom called me, and they told me, you know, we have a problem with the Nyeri County. You want us to go there, but we cannot put fiber. The county is charging us, I think it was 700,000 per kilometer,
yes,
to put in fiber. And I said, how are we going to manage this? So my first visit to the governor's office, we had that discussion. And he told me, that one, we're going to waiver. It does not make sense how we don't have technology as the thing driving Nyeri. And it was opened. Can you guess the first connection that was done in Nyeri County? There's a gentleman called Moheka. You know him?
Yes.
He's also very aggressive. Kept saying, I've seen people digging, and I'm being told it is fiber. Timai, Ninyamu Edago fiber. And it is going to pass near the day. He came and he was demonstrating to us technology, ICT SMS. When somebody delivers milk, they receive an SMS confirming their delivery, and they can take that to the bank and get money.
Yes.
So he was saying, can you quickly connect us to fiber so that we can make this even better? And we connected. You're not number one in Ajira by accident. It's not an accident. You have the right leaders who can see ahead, who are making the right investments that you're now very proud of. You never knew that the governor was responsible for that, did you?
No.
He took it upon himself. And the other things we said we would do, I know you're calling yourselves people Mukurwe-ini, but with the technology that you have, how many of you are from Nyeri? Is anybody here from Nyeri? Hakuna mtu wa Nyeri hapa? Who's from Kenya here? Who's from Africa? Wacheni mambo ya Mukurwe-ini peke yake. You're supposed to lead the continent.
Yes.
How can you lead the continent when all you're thinking about is Mukurwe-ini? All those other hubs that are being set up, can't you be the ones who will go and train and run and implement? Because you're ahead. Apart from exporting milk and yogurt, you can export Ajira. You can go out and tell everybody about the things that you have done, you have learned. Don't look only within Mukurwe-ini. Look at yourself as a Kenyan, as an African, and you're competing in the world. Those jobs that you're getting in Ajira, you're competing with people in Philippines, people in Australia, others in Africa, and you're winning, and you're getting money. So, please, you're not just at home in your world, in your sub-location, in your constituency or sub-county or county. You're an African and you can lead this continent and you can export. So that's very important. The other thing we had discussed with Governor was that we have this Nyarifo airstrip here. How can we have an airstrip but we never get a chance to fly? Everybody's going where? Last Friday we had the first flights now started. Mm-hmm. Every Friday there's a flight to Nyarifo from Nairobi.
Yes.
And those are going to be expanded. Which means, as you do your technology, as you make your money, it is 23 minutes to Nairobi. And if you have a lot of time, you get onto the train. So the train is working.
Yes.
Governor was in the same committee of governors that was saying we must have the train. But we have the train. And if that is not enough, sit your carriage when we are in Abuja. So all these things are happening. And I think I agree with Governor. You must look at the glass as half full, not half empty. Half full, not half empty. Because the future is now, and you're the future. You are 75.1% of the population of Kenya. You own Kenya. Si Kenya ni nyingi. The others, like me who are aspiring, we can even be in a WhatsApp group. They're not that many. But you keep thinking that everything must be done by us. No, you can do these things. That's why Tom Mboya, 29, was able to go to America when we didn't have a constitution here. He was able to go there and he was in the presidential campaign of John F. Kennedy, and they won. When Martin Luther King Jr. was making his speech, Tom Mboya had spoken before him on the same podium when he had a dream. And we did not have a constitution, he was able to do that. So you can do wonders yourselves. Don't wait for others to do them for you. The policy is a very important document. Because those people who want to make investment, those people who want to know what to do in an area, if there is no policy, it means there is no direction, it means things go whichever way you want. You go and you make an investment, tomorrow it changes because there is nothing that says this is what the plan is. And I want to thank the governor because he's taken it upon himself and his team to come and listen to all your views of the things that you want so that you can now be able to ensure that the policy you get will guide us even at the national level so that we know this is the Nyeri County policy. These are the things that they want to achieve. They align already with our policies, and therefore our investments can go there directly. The way we are working very closely with the Member of Parliament to ensure that you have all these Ajira centers. We went and we presented in Parliament to all the members of Parliament. We told them Ajira is a great opportunity for young people in your constituencies. Please take it up. We'll bring internet. We will bring in the computers, but please give us the space and run it so that we know you're taking care of it, and that's why you're bringing your youth. Bonakia came and how many has it done now? It's over 8. We only were giving 4. But those others who haven't done, we said, shall we have? Let him have more. And he's still asking for more. So we will continue to expand and increase. But my hope is that for yourselves, you can start building the businesses that Ajira allows you to build so that you start hiring and recruiting more people. Because if you're doing transcription, you can get work that will employ 1,000 people. And you give them that work. And they could be in the rest of the county. How will you become the headquarters of Ajira and freelancing by making sure you're also exporting to everybody else, your culture, your learning, but you do it by building your businesses, you employ them so that they can come and work with you. And because of the things that are coming from your policy, it is very easy for us as the national government to be able to come and partner and to work with you. On the issue of KEO, these are the Kenya Youth Employment Opportunities, that I already wrote to the World Bank. I think the people who were there before me had only chosen 17 counties. But I have written already and they said they are opening and Nyeri will be included. You shouldn't ask for more money because we have seen that it is working. We've had competitions, there's many grants that are being provided and we make sure that you get those. But we have also the youth fund, which can work very closely with your family, where we can provide even more funding for people here in Mukurwe-ini and in Nyeri County so that you can expand in your opportunities. But I think the most important thing is that you should know you came in this world alone and you will live alone. But it is very important to work together with others. Teamwork. Without teamwork, you cannot be able to go far. The way the governor is saying, you can come together, whether it is raising money, whether it is you raise money, get boda boda or matatu or whatever it is, it will allow you to do bigger and better things when you're together. But you, it will also keep you in the straight and narrow, away from going out into things that really don't help you. So I'll say me, I'm very pleased that I got this opportunity to come and talk with you. And if there's one thing that you should take away from this, is that you are important. And not everything comes from outside. You can also contribute. The way the governor is saying, there are things you will ask for, and you will probably be the ones on this side implementing those things. So take a look at the things that are important that must be done. Issues of tourism, that Mukurwe-ini, all of us want to come and see it. But where is it? So those of you who are online, you go up, you draw a map for people.
Yes.
And you put like a place there for tea.
Yes.
See, people will come and drink.
Exactly.
And if you're the head of the world, have you thought about that?
Yes.
If you're the head of the world,
yes,
you must be thinking for the
world.
You cannot just think for the head. See, yes. So you're thinking for the whole body.
Yes.
So if you're the head of the world, think of the whole world and start implementing. So may I hope by the next time I come, there'll be a nice hotel there where I can have tea.
Yes.
I can have the yogurt. All those things that you're talking about. That is tourism, that is trade, you know, that is culture. It is very many things all at once. And people will enjoy it. I think Mukurwe-ini is the one with the most interesting names, eh?
Yeah.
Or places. Celebrate that.
Have you heard about Mukurwe-ini?
We passed there. We passed there on the way here.
We have Lakima and the Lokuma.
So those of you who are in the creative sector, the creative industry, you should be taking full advantage. And this morning we actually went to the Wangari Maathai Center.
Yes.
That's the cultural center. We looked at it. I called KFC. This is the Kenya Film Commission and the Kenya Film Classification Board. I want them to work together and actually make that almost a national center for culture, for entertainment, for film. All these things we must do. And it is important. You know, there are people who've been asking me, you know, that I should be running for office here in Nyeri. You know, that would be a complete waste of time. Because we've been working so well with government.
Very good.
He's been delivering all the things that he has. But why would he be wasting time when he has all that experience? He's already got 5 years. Maybe after his next 5 years, we can look at him. Because now we can go and get training, coaching, and then you know, all the things that we need. But for that, you know, we also need businesses. We also need people to pay taxes. If all of us go into government, where are we headed? Yeah? So, you have seen what technology can do. Be wary of those people who are telling you otherwise. You know, I find it sometimes ridiculous that some people will try and tell you that you're less than who you are. How many of you go to church? And be honest. God says, you're wonderfully and fearfully made. And you're made in the image of God. Surely, how can you be anything less? This world is yours. This country is yours. This county is yours. So build on that. Don't break it. Don't go to these things where you're being made to think that you have no value, that you're only scrounging, yeah? That you can never get anything. That is a different narrative that you should be very afraid of. I'm sure you know what I'm talking about, and I'm not going to expound on it, but I know that where I came from. You know, even me, I came from a place called Tamadura. Yeah? The first school I went to, so I was born in Kuapera. I went to a school in Kamatora. Yeah? You don't know where it is? It's those sides of Limuru, very far. Although I came here in Nyeri in 1977. I don't look it, but I did. That's when I came here. But even coming from there where we were poor, I didn't even have shoes when I was going to school. Me, I have worked for the Queen of England. I've worked for her. I have worked for Google. I have worked for President Uhuru Kenyatta. You know, these are things that you hear about. There's no time I believe that these things will happen, but I worked for President Kenyatta. In fact, about 2 months ago, I was presenting at the UN Security Council to the other countries in the UN Security Council, talking about cybersecurity. Me from Mashinani. So when someone tells you you're from Mashinani, so you will always be in Mashinani and you'll always stay there, never believe them. There's no truth in that. It's what God has for you, and don't let anybody tell you anything else. Najua munajua mambo ya Mungu. So believe in God, He lives in you. He's not only in one place or in one destination that seems to always talk about these things of God. I have talked in the parables that the governor was saying we shouldn't, but I'm sure as young people you will be able to interpret for yourself. I know that the future is now, and you will determine your destiny. People who have experience have been able to do all the things. You want to see continuity. Flights, fiber, roads, railway, water, hospitals, all these things are being done. Do you want them to go backwards? Some of you may not know some areas we lived in. It would take an hour from Kiganjo to get to Nyeri. The road had been dug and you could not drive there. Any of you remember that? Probably not, you're too young.
Even this Mukurwe-ini, the road, destroyed. See, when munajua hii barabara, kutoka hapa kwenda Nyeri, until the other day, they itengenezwa.
People came and uprooted our roads. They uprooted our roads to make sure things cannot move. Our produce cannot move, our milk, our coffee, our tea. Tukae chonjo, tukae rada. Sindio? Mungu wabariki. Asanteni sana.